Good afternoon. Good morning, actually. So approximately 6 million years ago, the human race started. 200,000 years ago, they evolved into the modern day human beings. And 6,000 years ago, the first civilization started. And approximately 200 years ago, the Industrial Revolution took place. And now here we are with all the technology on our fingertips. So why is it that we guys are here and no other living being is where we are? It's only because of one thing, because we have a brain. And that brain is far superior than any other. So what is it about our brain which stands out? It can think, it can do cognitive thinking, it can emote, it can communicate, it can innovate, it can create. So it can do so many things, and yet we still don't know how to use our brain to our fullest capacity, right? Now, before I start, I'd like you to do something. Sir, can I ask you to help me out? I'm going to ask you to write down a four-digit number. I want you to write it down over here, and then I want you to give it to the person in the third row. And then the third row person writes down a four-digit number, and then they pass it on to the fifth row. Okay? I want 5 four-digit numbers. Okay? Yeah, four-digit numbers. All the 5 people write down 4-digit numbers. Okay? And don't let me see it. Just go back onto your... Sir? Yeah, just go back onto your chair so that I can't see it. Okay? Now, let me tell you why I'm telling you all of this. It's because I was reading this one article, a case study by Carnegie Mellon, and it said 85% of your financial success is because of the way you communicate, the way you lead, your personality, and your negotiation skills. And unfortunately, none of these things are taught in our schools. And my biggest regret in school was not learning sciences when I actually had the chance to. Because now all I do is just physics and chemistry. And these ladies over here know what I'm talking about because they help me make my show, which is You Got Magic with Neel Madhav, right? So now, in order for me to explain to you what I'm doing over here, I am going to do 3 experiments. This is the first experiment. Once you guys are done with this, I'm going to do the second experiment, and then I'm going to do the third experiment. Now, I like to take small, small things, put them together, and make it into something epic. And when I say epic, I mean it has to be beautiful, it has to be meaningful, okay? It has to be groundbreaking, and it has to be something probably, obviously, that no one else has done before, and it has to be for the greater good, so that everyone benefits from it. Now, creativity and innovation are two of the most integral things that any human being can look at. I'll tell you why, because creativity and innovation allows you to have a better personality. A better personality means better communication skills. Better communication skills, are you done? Can you fold it up first? Better communication skills means better negotiation skills. Better negotiation skills mean better leadership qualities. So I'm going to put this right on top of this so that no one tampers with it, and then we'll get to this later. So you punched in a four-digit number, then a four-digit number, then a four-digit number, then a four-digit number, and then you sent it, and we've kept it over there for right now. Okay? Now, let's do this. Can we have one volunteer up on stage? Just anyone come up, yeah? Sure, that excited lady over there. That's okay. Give her a round of applause, guys, come on. That's enough. All right, sorry. So let me explain to you what I'm going to do. I'm going to basically explain to you how creativity and innovation works. Because when you become a good leader, you end up becoming a more efficient person as a whole, right? Hi, please come on up. What's your name? Amogha, I'm Neel, nice to meet you. Please come up. Okay, so This is what innovation is. Innovation and creativity is all about solutions, okay? Magic is all about solutions. So I'm going to show you the same trick happen three different ways, okay? Now, take a card out, whichever one you want. Just point to it. Or this side. That's okay. This one? Go for it. Take it out. Okay? Show it to the audience so that they know what card you're thinking of. Right? So you can have the timer over here. Okay? Done? Perfect. You remember the card? Just put it over here, if that's fine. Okay? And this goes over here. Okay? We give it a shuffle. And now here's the thing. I said I'm going to show you the same trick three different ways. Okay? Now, the first card, the top card, the Two of Diamonds, this wasn't your card. Right? Can you come over here? Okay, so the Two of Diamonds, this wasn't your card, right? So we take the two, just hold it up, and it changes into the nine. Right? Now, this is one way of doing it. Right? Let me show you another way. Just make sure this is not a magic card or anything, just to make sure. Yeah? Just try to see if something's wrong with it or anything. Nothing's wrong with it, right? So, we take your card, okay, and we put it into the middle over here, right? This goes right in the middle over there. Now, just point to whatever you think is your card. Whichever one you think is your card. That's okay. This one? The King of Spades. That wasn't your card. Your card was the Nine of Spades. Can you just hold it like this? Yeah? Did it change? It changed into your card? Can you show it to everyone? See, now, that is the second way of doing it, right? And when you become good, or when you know enough about it, you can do it like this also. So the Nine of Spades, okay, we put it into the middle, somewhere over there, okay? Now, the top card, which is the Five of Clubs, that's obviously not your card, yeah? So now check this out. The Five, yeah? Just give it a wave, and it changes into the Nine of Spades, right? Now, this is pretty much the same trick done in three different ways. You can go now. Thank you very much. Give a round of applause, guys. Now, this is pretty much the same trick done in three different ways. It's like how I have come from Jaipur to Bangalore. You can either come by flight, or you can drive down, or you can take the train. There are three different ways, but it is for you to figure out which one do you want to do, right? Because your efficiency level is based on you. And you will figure out which method to use based on the following things. A, what's your target audience? Now, in order to figure out what your target audience is, you need to do a lot of research. You need to figure out what kind of people do you want to approach, right? So now, for me, at least, with some people, card tricks work. With some people, visual magic works. With some people, mentalism works, right? It's absolutely up to you to figure out how to go about doing what with the right person, right? Now, in terms of shooting, I've made, in terms of innovation and creativity, 130 different magic effects in the last 2.5 years for my television show. And out of all of these 130 magic effects, probably 100 would be absolutely brand new. Brand new in the sense that no one in the history of magic has ever done before. And 30 of them would be me taking a particular trick from here, a particular trick from there, a particular trick from there, and then mixing it all together and making it into something absolutely stunning, which is what I like. So I'm going to call upon... Can we have another spectator up on stage? Oh, now more hands go up. Great. Okay, let me not be sexist. This gentleman over here, come on up. Give him a round of applause, guys, please. Okay. So you'll need to run a little bit. I have 18 minutes. My bad. What's your name, sir? Samyak. I'm Neel. Nice to meet you. Come on up. Okay, now, hold the pencil. Yeah, I'm going to come back to that in a bit. I'm going to just run through the pages like this. Just say stop whenever you want. Here? Yeah? Okay. Take the pencil. Okay, take the pencil. Point it like this. Okay, and just make a small circle anywhere. Just to cover a word. Yeah, you got that? Okay, perfect. Have a look at the word, whatever you encircled. Can you do that? Yeah, is it one word or two words? It's one word. So can you remember that word?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Just close the magazine. Now, I need five more participants. Can we have five more people up on stage? Oh, great. Five people have stood up. Great. Please come on up. Give them a round of applause as well. Okay, so now here is Samyak. You have your phone in you? Yeah? Ladies, can you please come over there? Thank you very much. Samyak, I'd like you to come here. Okay? I think they've written numbers over here. I want you to add all of them up. Okay? I want you to add all of them up. And sorry, this is a little bit of this thing, but hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have Scrabble pieces over here, right? Just pick out a piece, whichever one you want, okay? And then we shall have a go. Now, here's the thing. Now, let me explain to you what my creative process is. In order for me to get something like this done, this is what I had to go through. I had to... have you guys watched the show Penn & Teller, Fool Us? Yes, okay? Some of you have. Okay, so what happened was that I was watching it with a friend of mine, and there were three consecutive episodes going on. And there were three people who fooled Penn & Teller. So my friend was like, you're giving a TED talk. Why don't you try to mix all the three effects and try to, you know, make an effect out of it? So which is what I did. So when I said I'm going to do three experiments with you, I did do three experiments with you, but they're all interconnected in a particular way. And let me show you how, right? Now, can you put your piece over here? 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 There you go. Okay, now, can you make a word out of this? Yeah? Guys, come on, man. Scrabble. You guys don't play Scrabble? Okay. Can you make the word? Okay, now, you have a word in your head that you took out from the magazine, right? Look, Aage, all of you guys, step a little Aage so that you guys don't see what I'm writing on the whiteboard. Okay, Samyak, just think of the word, look Aage, okay, don't look back. Just think of the word, think of how many letters there are. Okay. Can you guys all read this? Okay. I like this word. Okay, so can we have a mic? Can we have a mic? Or actually, hang on. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Oh, perfect. So, hold this. In a loud and clear voice, what was the word in the magazine?
Party.
Look at the back. Look there. Now, here's the thing. Now, here's the thing. These ladies came up and they took out those Scrabble pieces, right? And they took out whatever they wanted, right? It was absolutely random. Can you show what you guys picked out? Sorry, hang on. Whoa. Actually, hang on. Let me inverse it around. Pretty anticlimactic, I must say. I'm a party pooper. There you go, party. Okay, now, can someone zoom into this? Can you zoom into this? Now, the first thing that I asked you to do was I'd asked you to write down a number, right? You wrote down a number, you wrote down a number, you wrote down a number, and you wrote down a number, and we put it up over there, and then you added all of them up, right? For the first time, can you tell everyone what the number was?
The total number?
Yes, the total.
31,114. 31114.
31114.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, it is. It is. What is it?
3111.
Can the camera see this?
Wow.
31114. There you go. Give them a round of applause, guys. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
All right. So, now, in order for me to, now let me explain to you how I came about doing this. Okay? Now, there are three effects that are part of this. The first effect is where this gentleman wrote down the numbers and then passed it on. So first I needed to figure out how to get this, how to get these guys to write down numbers in a particular way for me, for them to actually add it up to 31114, right? I have 20 seconds more. Okay, I'm almost done actually. I had to figure out how to get them to do 311114. Right? And then I needed to figure out how to get the gentleman to circle around the magazine. And then I needed to figure out how to get the ladies to pick out those Scrabble words. Right? Obviously, I can't tell you how it's done. But, I'm sorry, magic secrets. However, innovation and creativity is a very integral part, and which is why I got together with a bunch of people from Harvard Business School, and we guys figured out how to create a package, an educational package for schools and universities, and which basically teaches them how to be better leaders, how to be better, you know, how to have better communication skills, how to have better negotiation skills, how to have a better personality, and how to innovate and how to create. And that is what I'm doing right now. And thank you guys for listening to me. Hope you guys had fun. Now it's time for me to party. See you guys.